Midsommar.
Is it scary?
Well, I wouldn't say scary. It's more disturbing. A bit brainwashing, if you may. But Midsommar is also an incredible visual experience. It really inverts how an horror movie is expected to look, which is bringing an even more compelling picture. For example, the film chooses to use light and pop colors in bright environments, which is a contrast for the dark and lifeless aesthetic of horror pieces. The opening scene shows the contrast between two worlds, the Swedish world, that will be introduced later on, against the city where the main character Danny lives. It uses mobile framing to introduce the aspects of a picture. For example, to show family photos and props that are related to future events of the film. Later on, Danny's sobbing after finding about her sister and parents' death. The frame starts wide and closes into her window where there's snow outside, which sets the mood for the sadness by using a blue tone. Strategic framing also reveals important props used to tell subliminal messages. Christian constantly gaslights her, which puts him in a higher angle of the frame. But whenever Danny is talking with Pelle, which talks to her as an equal, the camera positions them on the same level. Inserts are only used to show very important pieces of the information, such as the sister's suicidal message, which is kind of a motif that comes back and back again throughout the film. Is stronger at the beginning when she has a fresh trauma on her death, but at the end is a subliminal motif on the background when Danny finally accomplishes her control on the situation. The pain is also another motif you would see in this film. It's meant to be accepted first by the elders that sacrifice themselves because their lives reach the end on the eyes of the village, but also when Danny sees her boyfriend cheating on her, she shares the pain. And this is something that it's very important to her because she was always hiding her emotions. She was always pretending to be okay, but the moment she's able to share her pain with the people around her, it means so much to her that she becomes in control of her emotions. Again, on inserts, you can see on Danny's tapestry a bear, which is an important symbol at the end of the film, and also a small story that is shown later on to explain one of the rituals that are performed in the village. The cinematographer also chose to use a short focal length, which allows for a wider field of view. This was very useful for the story, and it starts being more used when the characters arrived in a small secluded community. This technique allows the frame to have layers. Multiple actions happen in the foreground, midground, and background. This is not only a good visual technique, but also a good storytelling one. It suddenly tells us more, almost feel like there is more than one story being told. The one we actually are meant to see, and the one that is clearly happening and happening in the background. The blocking and actions and the background actors really add to the overall scene composition. Furthermore, the use of psychedelic visuals builds up the anxiety the characters are feeling. The scenes Danny's under influence of psychedelics make use of visual effects that create the sense of dizziness, that everything is pulsing or melting, which at first is very noticeable to us, but at some point, the psychedelic visual cues turn out to be more normal to us, the audience, just if it was meant to be there. Even the flower in her crown is pulsing, along with the distorted faces around her. But we don't seem to notice that while we're watching the film, since it's just a normal aspect of the composition and the picture itself. Midsommar is a very unique film, with clever audio and visual cues. They're really powerful, and the work of the director and cinematographer together really summed to create a whole new experience for the viewers.